Hello students, I'm Ashok Kumar, your English teacher, and today I'm going to make a video for the students of class 6. Today I will discuss paragraph writing from writing section. But before starting today's discussion, I would like to say a few words. I hope you will be following the instruction of our government to fight with the COVID-19 coronavirus disease and will be staying at home, maintaining social distance. And in this trying time, you must remember one thing, that hum honge kamyab, ye waqt na thehra hai, ye waqt na thehrega, means ye jo samay hai, ये ज़्यादा देर तक रहने वाला नहीं है, सब कुछ नॉर्मल हो जाएगा. अपने आप पर विश्वास बनाए रखें, घर से ना निकलें और अपनी फैमिली को और अपने फ्रेंड्स को इस बीमारी से दूर रखें. विद दीज लाइन्स आई स्टार्ट टुडेज डिस्कशन विद सम ऑफ द पिक्चर्स. सो सी व्हाट इज देयर इन द पिक्चर्स. You have to identify these pictures. What do you see in this picture? So identify. Another picture is there. Identify this picture also. What do you see in this picture? This is the third picture. Identify this also. I hope you have identified the pictures. So let us know what was there in these pictures. In the first picture, we saw Swaran Mandir, which is situated at Amritsar. In the second picture, there is a hospital building. In the third picture, there is a school. I think an American school. So today we will learn how to dwell a paragraph. So this is the new heading, paragraph development. I will tell you how we can dwell the information in the form of paragraph. So to write a good paragraph, you must ask questions from yourself. Like, if you have to write a paragraph on the topic my school, you can ask some questions from yourself, and after answering these questions, you have to jot down the answers together in a series to develop the information in the form of a paragraph. Now see how you can do this. So today's topic we will cover is my school, and how you will develop your paragraph. So first of all, you have to ask questions from yourself. So let us see what kind of question you must ask from yourself. First question, you can see here, in which school do you study, or what is the name of your school? Where is it situated? How far is it from your home? And your answers would be, first question, I study in KB Nullity. Second question's answer, it is situated in Kangra district of Himachal Pradesh. How far is it from your home? It is 7 kilometers from my home. You can mention other digits. 3 kilometers, 2 kilometers, 5 kilometers. Means you mention only that figure which is applicable. Means if school is 5 kilometers away from your home, you will write 5. If it is 2 kilometers away, you can write 2. So it depends upon you how far it is from your home. Now let's see. There is another set of questions. What is the name of the principal of your school? What kind of a person is your principal? How many teachers are there in your school? Your answers would be: the name of the principal of my school is Mrs. Swati Agarwal. This would be your answer. Then second question: what kind of person is your principal? She is very caring and helping person. This would be your answer. How many teachers are there in your school? So your answer may be: there are 30 teachers in my school. There is another set of questions. What is the name of your class teacher? Who teaches you English? How many rooms are there in your school? And your answers would be for these questions. For the first question's answer, you will write: the name of my class teacher is Mr. Manish. You can write if your class teacher is changed in that way. Who teaches you English? So your answer may be: Mr. Manish teaches us English. You can write the teacher if it is changed, his name also. How many rooms are there in your school? So there are 20 rooms in my school. Or if this digit is different, you can write that digit also. Now there are certain questions also. How many playgrounds are there in your school? What games do you play in your school? How do you like your school? And your answers would be: there are 2 playgrounds in my school. I play football, cricket and volleyball there. I like my school very much. So these were certain questions which you will ask from yourself, and you yourself will answer them. And once you answer these questions, you will have to jot down all the answers in a series, and that will become a paragraph. Now see how. My school, this is the paragraph written by us. I study in KB Naleti. It is situated in Kangra district of Himachal Pradesh. It is 7 kilometers far from my home. The name of the principal of my school is Mrs. Swati Agarwal. She is a very kind and caring and helping kind of person. There are 30 teachers in my school. The name of my class teacher is Mr. Manish. Mr. Manish teaches us English. There are 20 rooms in my school. There are 2 playgrounds in my school. I play football, cricket and volleyball there. I like my school very much. So in this way, we have given answers to certain questions, and all the answers are written in a series, in a sequence, and that has made a very good paragraph. In this way, you can write any paragraph on any topic. Your technique should be same. First, you will ask certain questions regarding the topic. Then you will provide answers to those questions. And you have to write all the answers in a series or in a sequence. And that would be a paragraph. Another thing which I want to tell you, that once you have written a paragraph, you will not leave any space between. Otherwise, when you start again, it will not be a paragraph, then it will become essay. See, if you start writing a paragraph, your first word and last word, You see here, you have begun your paragraph from the first word, and it is end here. If you give space between these words, means you start from another line from here, then it would not be a paragraph. And if you write again from here, then it will also not be a paragraph. So paragraph means it starts from first word and it ends with the last word. There is no space in between. So this thing you will always keep in mind. Now let's do some other activities. Fill up the blanks with correct form of the given verb. Now see verb. These all are verbs. And you have to select one verb which is applicable here, 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 and here from these. In that way, it will be completed. And you can take hints because this information is given there in the paragraph also. Now see there. Now this is subject. So 20 is a plural. So find out plural verb. Then my school. It is singular. So use the verb which is used with singular subject. Then again, we is plural, so use that verb which is used with plural subjects. I is also considered as plural, so use the verb which we used with plural subjects. Now, see what is there in the second activity. This is very easy for you. Take the old one. Old one means which is not related to school. Those words which are not related to school, you must take them. Activity 3, crossword puzzle. Find out the names of things that you generally come across in your school. So you have to pick out those words from these letters which are generally linked with school. Same activities again there. You have to go through this activity also. Now this is home assignment. This work you will do on your notebooks. So three paragraphs you will have to write. My home, table, chalk. And certain hints are given also there. Location, if you are writing a paragraph on my home, you must mention its location, house number, color, number of rooms, residence, and the things which made this house, etc. Means you can add little bit from yourself. Table, if you are writing a paragraph on table, you must tell about its shape, color, material, its use, its purpose, etc. And if you are writing a paragraph on chalk, you must tell in your paragraph its shape, color, material, uses, and purpose. So this is home assignment for you. Thank you. That's all for today. Have a nice day.